First impression, I'm not too sure how I feel about this. Oh, I'm going for my necklace. Becca, what are you doing? From far away, it looks really good. I feel like it could be a little creamier and more blendable into the... Oh, I got it already. I would not buy this again. This is so painful, you guys. Okay, it's not painful. Hey guys, it's Becca here. Welcome to my channel, or you know what? Welcome if you are new. Today I am doing a first impression one brand makeup tutorial. Oh my gosh, that was such a mouthful. I've also finished an entire bottle of wine during this tutorial or first impression review, whatever you call it. Let's pop this bottle. So I've been drinking this and it's so good. It tastes like unfiltered sake. So sweet. I think that's the reason why I love it so much. Okay, first I want to fill in brows. What I'm using, I got the micro brow pencil. I like that it comes with a spoolie and a really small tip. That way I can be super precise with my brows. Got it. Color taupe. Let's brush it. I'm gonna move my mirror a little closer. It's kind of hard to see. That is so good. Okay, I'm gonna fill them in. I have really light brows, so I think I should have gotten like a darker shade. I guess I can fill this in and then go back over with my brush. I've been so used to like light color because my hair, but now that my roots are growing out, I feel like I should have picked a darker shade. So I would say that I like it. What do you guys think? It's a little light. My brows are never the same. Never. Because this, I feel like my left arch is higher. But I'm really liking this. The pigment is there. It's really easy to glide on. Yeah, I really like it. Now, I just have to go in with like my usual shade to define it a little more. But I really like this. So I usually use like a tight liner brush to go in to define my brows, and I use like a liner just so I can create like a hair-like stroke. This is what I do to create my brows. It's so weird to me to talk on screen, like I'm still trying to get used to it. That is basically what I do to my brows. I'm really liking this taupe color because it's giving my brows a little of like that natural shading. So next, I'm gonna use this brightener and radiance. Ooh, it's a little pink, but it glides on very well. Okay, I'm just gonna do this. If it shows up weird, we'll just have to go over with some concealer. So I'm just gonna blend this now using this brush, Real Technique. I'm gonna blend it crazy, but I'm not gonna spend too much time blending here because we're gonna go over with some concealer. But first, I am going to use this primer. I've heard like really good things about this primer, so let's see. This is the Studio Photogenic Primer Base. What does it do? Okay, it's supposed to be lightweight, water-based, universal color, and formulated without parabens, which is great for the skin. I always, it's blue. My camera is not going to focus, but I'm just gonna apply this all over my skin. Oh my god, I think I got too much. Oh, that looks so bad. Okay, I'm not tipsy yet, I swear. First impression, I'm not too sure how I feel about this because it's giving my skin a white cast, and that is not what I want. I'm just gonna wait a little bit for it to set in. I mean, tap it in into my skin, onto my lips. So far, I like it. It's not too sticky. Yeah, it's super lightweight, definitely. Just, I don't like how it's so blue. I'm gonna apply a little bit on my nose. This is where I sweat a lot. Oh my gosh, you guys. Very clumpy a little bit, and it's not blending seamlessly. Maybe after I have to apply my makeup or my foundation to be able to really judge it. Okay, so now we're gonna apply foundation. This is also the HD. I got it in the sand beige because have olive undertone, and usually like that is the key word for foundation. Hopefully it's not too light. That's how much I am applying. Let's do this. Okay, this is like a little light coverage because I can still see my birthmark, and I'm using a lot, you guys. Maybe I'm supposed to be applying this with a brush, not a beauty blender, but it's pretty lightweight. It feels nice on the skin. It doesn't cover as much as I want. That's what concealer is for, right? Hopefully the concealer I got isn't too light for my skin either. I'm pretty pale. I knew I forgot something. I forgot to get a contour and highlight shade. It's so light. This would have been great for like winter because that's usually the time when I am at my lightest. From far away, it looks really good. And it feels really light on the skin too. Like my pores are not clogged. That's how I feel. Blend it. Oh, I'm going over my necklace. Becca, what are you doing? I'm gonna go down here too. Just because I'm so light that you can see all my veins. Like, look at my neck. Yep. The struggle is real. So this is the concealer that I'm using. Okay, so it's for dark circle and cancels out the blue of dark circles. I kind of have a little, do I have dark circles? Oh shit. Okay, so I'm just gonna apply that. I'm actually gonna use a brush this time. I feel about this concealer. It's too pink. Too pink for me. I guess that is supposed to cancel out the dark circles. I don't know if it's my skin today, but I just feel like it could be a little creamier and more blendable. I think it's good. I'm gonna go ahead and, because it's so light, I'm gonna use it all over to contour. Also gonna define my cheek, just bringing it forward a little, right under the cheekbone. So because I forgot to get like a contour kit, I'm going to use the eyeshadow, one of the eyeshadow color in the palette, just to get the job done. I always do that though, so it's not something new. Done with the concealer. I mean, coverage, it looks good. I'm just gonna pat it in, but it's not doing a bad job at all. Next, I'm using the Studio Photogenic HD setting powder, or it's like a finishing powder. This reminds me of the Tarte setting powder, if you know which one I'm talking about. I haven't used like any different setting powder aside from the one that I've been using. I'm not too fond of this at all. It's so white. Oh, I'm just gonna brush it off. I'm not loving it. Okay, on to the next. I'm going to do the eyeshadow. This is what I got. The Warm Neutrals. Okay, I'm gonna use this brush and go in with a transition shade. I'm gonna use probably that one right there. It doesn't have a name. Okay, not bad. It's really good actually. This reminds me of the Morphe. I forgot the name. I will have to let you guys know in the description below. Just blend, blend, blend. So far, so good. Next, I am going in with a different brush. This is like the e.l.f. brush. It's so cheap and it does the job. Usually I would just throw it out 2 months or so. Get a new one. It just works better that way. I guess that's how it is when you get like a cheap brush. You have to just decide whether it's disposable or not. Like, do you have the funding to dispose of it every 2 months? So I'm going in. Oh, I forgot. Going in with this shade right here on the outer corner. So you always want to tap the extra products off your brush. That way it applies more evenly. And I'm just applying this like from here to where my pupil is. And you just want to keep your brush there. I'm such a lightweight, you guys. Like, one glass of wine. I'm feeling a little tipsy already. That is why I can't really hang. Which is good, you know? Like, you don't need a lot of alcohol to get drunk. So, yep. I'm just gonna blend it a little more. I'm gonna go back in with this brush. The key to flawless eyeshadow is to blend. Okay. I'm gonna do the same with the bottom. Actually, gonna use this one on the bottom. Give it a little more life. Always want to go lighter on my bottom and the top. Again, I'm gonna use that shade and put it right here, just a little bit above the crease, and then I'm gonna leave room here just for my eyeliner. Now, let's see, I'm gonna go in with this color. I'm gonna use that color for my crease, and I'm gonna use that color on my lids. I think I'm gonna use my finger on this one just because I feel like it will blend better. Ooh, this is so pretty. I'm gonna pop it right on top. Oh, I like that. It's like a glittery suede color. First impression of this eyeshadow palette, I would give it a 9. And it blends well. I haven't had a problem. Okay. Now I'm taking that color. I'm gonna use this shading brush. Just gonna use this color. Pop it right there. I'm gonna use this color to highlight too. What do you guys think? Pretty simple yet really easy to do. Okay, now I'm gonna go in with liner. This is Tube Timer. The reason why I got this is because I can tight line on one side and do a wing line on the other side. So I'm gonna start right here. Glide very easy. I'm used to that Kat Von D liner. I'm not sure if I'm liking. Oh, you gotta put pressure on it. We'll see the end results. But so far, I'm not too sure about this look. It's not distributing evenly. See what happened there? Because the brush, like, look. Like, okay, this is, and it's like part of the brush is dry already. Okay. I would not buy this again because I just made my liner thicker. Means I have to go back to the side. Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh, I just poked myself in the eye. I'm going to use this side. Hopefully this side is better. Tight line. Oh, I just poked myself. This is so painful, you guys. Okay, it's not painful, it's just me being dramatic. This would be a funny, like, boyfriend does my voiceover because he would say some crazy shit. Okay, that is not cute. Oh my gosh, this is one of those where you just keep on adding on and then it just becomes super dramatic. I think I'm gonna do like a smoky eye now. Gonna be pretty happy if it turns out just decent. Decent. Not well, just decent. Boom. Okay, I'm not done. I'm gonna go back in with the Tube Timer. Gonna do the bottom liner, just connecting this to the top. This just opens my eye a little bit more. I don't like to go all the way into the- Oh! Oh, I got drunk already. This is a fail, you guys. Like, this is a fail. Okay, this is not cute. This is getting out of hand. I need to stop. Okay, I have to smoke that out too. I'm gonna end up smoking everything out, you guys. Does it look even? I'm not sure if I'm drunk or not. Okay, I'm gonna smoke this because I'm not liking it. I'm using this color right here just to lighten the bottom liner. It's gonna blend. And then if I have any fallout or anything, I'm just gonna go back in with the foundation. Okay. That doesn't look too bad. Hopefully after I contour my face, it won't be too light. Highlighter a while ago for under my brows to do my waterline. See? Can you tell? I'll show you how long it is. And dark. I love it. It is definitely my must-have. Okay, this is weird, but this is what I do to my bottom lashes. Just curl it. Oh my god. Did I just rip my lashes up? Okay. I'm a little whiny when I have alcohol in me. That's just how I am. Some people like that. And some people just hate it. But you know, you just gotta be yourself. Okay, here's the mascara that I got. First time for everything. Oh, not bad. If I was doing like a simple look, I would just not put on fake lashes. I really like this mascara. Yep, this is a rebuy for me. And I think it was cheap too. It wasn't like that much. I'll definitely link or under the description below, I'll let you guys know the price. Each of the products. I got this at Target. So I just need to go in with some blush. This is the blush that I got. So let's try this out. Because I have an olive undertone, I feel like coral colors, like more orangey, blends better with my skin tone. Ooh, this is so pretty. So I'm just gonna do this. Ooh, that's a lot. Crazy with the blush. Now I'm gonna use a airbrush brush. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my eyeshadow palette. I'm gonna use that color, like I said, mix with this color. It up. The only thing that I don't like about this, why it's a 9 and not a 10, is because it has a lot of fallouts. Brush it up. Lift that face. I think that looks good. Now I'm gonna go in with the same thing and I'm gonna contour my face with a different e.l.f. brush. This is why I love like cheap brushes, because I don't have to constantly like cleaning my brushes for different application. You know, you get to have the same type of brush with different colors. So it's just less time consuming for me. So I'm gonna dip it in that, dip it in this, dip it back in that, tap the extra products, So this is kind of tricky. This is what I do. You inhale. While you're inhaling, your nostrils are sunking in and you're able to see your true nose shape. So this one do. Don't forget about this because it will give more definition in your lips and it will make your chin look longer. That's what I have been doing for the longest time. So just do it again. Also, this is important because you want to go in right here where your cupid, between your cupid's bow, because that will give your upper lip the definition that you want. Like, it brings your lip forward when you put on lipstick. Yeah, I don't know if I'm explaining this very well, but this is what I do. See the difference? And then once you do that, use the e.l.f. contour brush. Good, because you can start from here and just push it up. When you push the darker shade up, it'll just lift. So like, instead of brushing it down, it'll make your nose look lower than it is. Then brushing it up will make your nose look like it's more lifted, which creates a higher definition. You know what I mean? I'm terrible at explaining. But yeah, this is what you do. I'm really loving this. This is a repurchase and a keep for me. Next, I am using this again to highlight. And I'm gonna go in with this eyeshadow brush. It's a Real Technique. Again, I use it to highlight. And I'm gonna go in with this, the same shade that I put in between my inner corner. Tap it right there. And right here, you just wanna leave a little gap right there, just so it defines your nose. And then the highest point also underneath. Don't worry, I'm gonna blend that later. Just apply that right there. Cupid's bow. Puck out your lips so you can really see where to apply it. And do this. Apply it right there. Now I'm going to use, when I clean my brush, I'm going to use the opposite side and just blend. Lighter than my body, I'm gonna go in. See how much fallout? Okay, I'm gonna go in with this color, the one that I used to mix the contour. I use it under my chin just to define it a little more, and around my face, especially right here where my hairline is, just to blend it. I'm gonna use the same shades for contour. So you just wanna puck, or do this thing with your chin, right? You see the true shape of your chin, right? So where it's protruding out, like the shadow, you want to fill that in. So like for me, it's like from here to there. From here to there. That's exactly where I'm gonna put my contour. See what it does? It like brings your chin out. And then I'm just gonna blend it. And then if you want, this is optional. Like if you do want to bring this part out because you have like, you don't have a sunken cheek, you have like chubby cheeks, this is what you do. So you just grab a brush. I'm using a setting brush and I'm using the lightest color here. If you have a contour palette, it'll work better. Remember where I applied the highlighter? That's where you're gonna apply this powder. I came with the lashes. I'm not gonna cut my lashes just because these ones fit my eyes. So I'm gonna use this. One of the tips for applying false lashes is after applying on the glue, you wanna play with the strip so that it's not so hard to apply on your lash line as your eye shape. So it's not like, you know, like for example, like this one, how curled it is. If you apply it on, like it's that shape. But if you play with it, you'll be able to apply it on just a lot easier. And then you want to just wait until it's a little tacky to apply it. I like to just apply it with my fingers. And if you don't have time to wait for it to dry, this is what you can do. You can stick it to your brush like this and wait for the glue to get tacky. I'm gonna finish this bottle by the end of this video. Oh, actually I just finished it. Woo! So after like 15 seconds, other end to infuse my actual lashes with the falsy. I am going to finish this look off with some mascara on my brows. Just apply this with the direction of your hair. So like right here, my hair is growing that way. I'm gonna brush it up. And right here, my hair is growing downward and I'm going to follow it. That will give you more definition in your brows and it won't make it look so blocky. This is in the shade, what is this? Tea and Cookies. The reason why I got this is because, again, my skin tone, I don't want to get anything that won't look right on my skin tone. Ooh, this is pretty. ugly face, huh? I usually don't use a brush, which I should. I don't. And then I'm gonna go in with my favorite shade just because this matches my skin tone more. This is in the shade Canes. Oh, I love this shade. It just complements my skin more. A lip renewing serum just because my lips are dry all the time. It comes in a capsule. This is not NYX. This is the product that I saw on my website. I would not recommend you guys to stuff that I don't believe in. So this is a must have, especially if you are over the age of 30 and you're losing that lift in your cupid's bow, you need this. This like fills in the fine lines of your lips, so it just gives it more of a plumpier definition. Another one brand review, let me know in the comments below and I'll get that going for you. Products that I would repurchase is definitely the eyeshadow, brows, mascara. Those are my three repurchase of this review. So, thank you for watching!